Back in November, I attended Microsoft Ignite in San Francisco. Microsoft Ignite is Microsoft's annual conference where they lay out their roadmap for Windows, Microsoft 365, Azure, and now, of course, AI. Full disclosure, Microsoft covered my travel to Ignite, but they did not review or approve this video. I wasn't just watching keynotes or walking the show floor. I also sat down with the teams building Windows and Edge, and I also attended an Ask Me Anything session with Microsoft's leaders on responsible AI. Since then, I've had some time to reflect on everything that was announced, and the more I connected the dots, the clearer Microsoft's AI strategy became. Ignite really wasn't about just new AI features. It was about something much bigger. AI agents that can take action, built directly into the tools people already use, and designed in a way that enterprises can trust. In this video, I'll break down what Microsoft is really building with AI, why this Ignite mattered, and what it means for how work's going to change over the next year or two. This Ignite felt different from past years. In previous conferences, AI often felt experimental. You'd see impressive demos, but it wasn't always clear how those ideas would translate into real work at scale. This time, Microsoft was much more direct. They openly talked about where AI has struggled, why many AI projects fail, and what needs to change for AI to deliver value. Instead of focusing on one product or one big feature, Microsoft kept coming back to the same idea. AI needs to move from something you try to something that quietly runs work in the background. That shift in tone was noticeable. Less hype, more accountability, and it sets up everything else Microsoft announced at Ignite. The big idea behind Ignite was simple but important. Microsoft is shifting from AI that answers questions to AI that actually does work. They describe this shift using agents. Agents are AI systems that can take actions, follow steps, and work across tools on your behalf. Copilot is the interface people see, but the real change is happening behind the scenes, where agents are embedded into tools like Excel, Teams, Windows, and even the browser. The goal is not more AI features. It's less friction, AI handling routine work quietly while people stay in control. Once you see that, Ignite stops feeling like a collection of announcements and starts to feel like a single strategy. One of the most interesting conversations I had at Ignite was with Pavan Davuluri, who leads Windows and Devices. What became very clear from that conversation is that Microsoft no longer sees AI as something that just lives inside individual apps. For Microsoft, that shift starts with Windows itself.
Forward, I think we start with this notion, Kevin, of making sure Windows is the most secure and trusted platform, that people have a sense of trust, confidence, and familiarity with.
So Windows becomes the foundation where AI can safely run, and that includes a hybrid approach with some AI running in the cloud and some running directly on your device.
In scenarios where we can celebrate the fact that you have the ability to use AI in the cloud combined with AI on your device are the ones where I think we as a company will really differentiate ourselves on and puts us in a place where I think we have more value to add to our customers.
Running AI directly on your PC allows Windows to understand what's happening on your screen, respond faster, and keep certain tasks private. And that's what enables Windows to change how you interact with your PC.
And we started with mouse and keyboard, and now we have the capabilities like voice and vision that are powered by Copilot. So that changes, in my mind, the interaction model, adds new multimodal capabilities to the platform.
The simplest way to think about this is this. Windows is becoming the secure place where AI actually does work, not just the surface where apps run. That same shift shows up very clearly in the browser. I also sat down with Sean Lindersay, who leads Microsoft Edge.
People think that they're kind of done, they're a commodity, and for a long time they kind of were, right? It was a thing that you kind of fired up, and it was a tool to get to the web. And people sort of like, well, what more do I need? It starts up, it shows my web pages.
Sean's point was that AI changes what a browser can be. Edge is no longer just a viewer for the web.
But as the power of the AI has gotten, as power has become more available and more accessible to more people, we're now able to do things that we really kind of science fiction in the past, right?
In this model, the browser doesn't just show you websites. It actually does things for you. It becomes the agent.
You can speak to your browser and say, hey, do this thing for me.
Instead of you visiting 10 different sites, copying information, and jumping between tabs, the browser becomes the agent that visits those sites for you.
Well, I'm just going to go and ask my AI browser to go do that for me. And it's going to open up a bunch of tabs in the background, go to finds, and it's going to find one and then say, hey, I found one with the requirements you had.
What really matters here is that this is designed for work, not just convenience.
That secure enterprise part is actually really, really, really important.
That's the key difference. This is not just a shortcut bolted onto a browser. It's a browser designed to safely do real work on your behalf. When you take a step back and look at Windows and Edge together, Copilot starts to make more sense. Copilot's not the worker. Copilot's the front door. It's where you describe what you want to get done. Behind Copilot are agents that operate across Windows, the browser, Microsoft 365 apps, and Azure services. Some handle documents, others analyze data, others respond to security events or IT issues. That consistency is what stood out at Ignite. Instead of disconnected AI features, Microsoft is aligning everything so AI works the same way across Windows, the browser, and Microsoft's apps. Copilot's the interface and agents do the work behind the scenes. As AI becomes more capable, responsibility becomes more important, not less. At Ignite, Microsoft was very clear about this. AI doesn't fail because it lacks intelligence. It fails when people cannot trust it or control it. That risk increases dramatically once AI can take actions. A wrong answer is one thing. A wrong action inside a business system is another. This is why Microsoft kept emphasizing observability, testing, and governance, meaning the ability to see what AI is doing, test it under pressure, and control how it's used. It's also why enterprises allow Copilot but block random AI tools. Responsible AI is not about slowing things down, it's about making AI safe enough to actually use at scale. In practical terms, this means you'll spend less time tab hopping and more time telling the system what you want done. AI won't feel like something new you have to learn. It'll work inside the tools you already trust. And in many cases, the biggest improvements will be the ones you barely notice. That's the real story of Ignite. Not smarter AI, but quieter AI that just does the work. After talking with the people building this, one thing is clear. Microsoft isn't trying to win AI headlines. They're trying to make AI boring, dependable, and embedded everywhere. And that might be the most disruptive move of all. If they get this right, AI won't feel like something you have to adapt to. It'll quietly remove friction from the tools you already use. That's a real shift Ignite pointed at. Let me know what you think about this format down below in the comments. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.